Now, there's great news for our Great Barrier Reef. Coral has made a comeback. The region is right now in wonderful condition, recording its highest amount of coral in nearly four decades of monitoring.
Managing Director of Great Barrier Reef Legacy and Project Director of Living Coral Biobank, Dr. Dean Miller, joins us now for more. Dean, thanks so much for joining us this morning. Coral's bounced back across two-thirds of the reef. It's pretty exciting. How much should we be celebrating this?
It is very exciting, and I think in what's been a very turbulent time for the Great Barrier Reef in the last 6 years, we've had four mass bleaching events. We do need to celebrate this as a win. It does show a level of resilience of this largest living structure on the planet, and we are seeing that recovery process take place. So I think we can say that this is exciting.
Oh, it really is. There's still plenty of work to be done, no doubt, but what is behind this record growth?
Yeah, look, you really need to have a look at the data and see what's going on here. The record growth comes on the back of a record low, unfortunately. So, as I said, four mass bleaching events in the last 6 years, 2016, 2017, devastating events really for the far northern and the central section of the Great Barrier Reef, then 2020, and then most recently this summer just gone, 2022. And the first three were in El Nino events, which is kind of predicted to be quite warm and very hot, and that's where we saw the biggest bleaching impact. And then this one just gone was a La Nina. So this is a season where we're supposed to see a lot of rain and turbulent weather and keep temperatures low. But again, we saw bleaching across the entire Great Barrier Reef. And I think the southern area of Queensland and northern New South Wales got a lot of our rain. We saw lots of flooding in Lismore, for instance. So look, it's got to be taken with a grain of salt. This is only one of 36 years. We have seen a lot of, I guess, coral mortality in that last big period. Over 50% of the Great Barrier Reef coral cover has been lost. So what has happened is opportunity, really. So if you think of this as a big bushfire that's gone through, what happens after a bushfire are these pioneer species or quickly growing species come up on the forest floor and they grow as fast as they can. And that's simply what we're seeing here in this recovery phase.
Yeah, some scientists have said that the increased coral cover could be short-lived. Is that what you're sort of feeling as well? Could that be the case?
Yeah, it could be, because what the coral cover is made up of is this type of coral, which is an acropora. It's a very fast-growing type of coral. This makes the branching coral and the plate corals. Thankfully, this is the ones that the tourists really love to see as well. But they can grow really, really fast, about 16 centimetres per year. Now, they're also extremely susceptible to wave energy, cyclone events. They can get smashed apart, which also helps them grow, because if they land in a favourable spot, they can actually regenerate. But they're the most susceptible to coral bleaching, so that's the warmer heat stress events. Crown of thorn starfish love to eat these as well. So it really is a question of what's going to happen in the future. We don't know what this means for biodiversity, and that's a real fundamental question when we're thinking about the Great Barrier Reef. There's 400 different species of coral, and what we might be seeing out there is about 20 or 30 species doing extremely well. What we want is for the whole system to recover, and that takes about 10 to 15 years on a given reef, provided you have no more coral bleaching, no more cyclone events, no more crown of thorns, and that's looking relatively unlikely. So, there's still a long way to go for full recovery on the Great Barrier Reef. And fingers crossed, I mean, we're doing everything we can.
Yeah, tell us about what you're doing. You're leading a groundbreaking project working to preserve the coral biodiversity. Tell us about the work of the Living Coral Biobank.
Absolutely. I'm here at holding facility number one right now, capable of holding 8,000 live coral fragments. Our plan is to collect every living species of coral on the Great Barrier Reef and put them in these style tanks, kind of like a coral ark. So you encourage all the living representatives onto your vessel, and you bring them here and keep them alive. When they come here, the clock is literally stopped. We can hold their temperature, the water, nutrients, the light levels. Everything in here is kept perfect. So when they're sitting in these tanks, it's like a luxury apartment, and we can basically hold them for as long as we want. Corals are amazing animals. They can live for hundreds, if not thousands of years under the correct conditions. So they make the perfect type of animal to hold in a living coral biobank. And right behind me are 132 different species, or about 33% of the biodiversity of the Great Barrier Reef, held here for their ultimate conservation, and then to be made available for research and restoration efforts. So this is the full living data backup of the Great Barrier Reef right here.
There's some gorgeous colours in there at the moment, Dean. Are there certain corals that might struggle to come back, do you think, on the Great Barrier Reef? Some that might need a little bit of extra love and care?
Absolutely. And look, with every coral bleaching event, what we're losing is the most vulnerable species. So you've got that list of 400, but the ones that aren't making it through those heat stress moments are slowly dropping off the bottom of that list. And it's our job to get them in here into the biobank and actually hold them, and collect what's out there for today so we can have on hand for tomorrow. The different colours that you see are the symbiotic algae living within the tissue, because corals actually take the sun's light and convert it into sugar and create energy for themselves. And they're kind of like an off-grid house, if you will. So the algae within the tissue recycles the coral's waste. And don't forget, the coral is an animal. And through this symbiotic relationship, they've been able to build the largest living structure on the planet. So it's a very clever system, but it's this system that's breaking down with heat stress and I guess global warming.
Wow. All right.
Well, Dean, it's been an absolute pleasure chatting with you this morning. We know you're working incredibly hard to restore the reef to its former glory, but certainly up against it with climate change, aren't we? Dean, thanks again for joining us, and congrats on those green shoots on the Great Barrier Reef. It's very exciting.
My absolute pleasure. Have a great morning.